practice? You build off, you throw it out, you know, how do you...
You learn from it. And it's easier to learn when you come out on top, I believe. You don't need to lose games like this to learn of squandered opportunities and from the mound, of not throwing strikes. I've heard some of the numbers, and it's pretty remarkable. You know, I know I want to say at least with the two errors we created from the mound, at least 18 free base runners. That isn't what we try to teach in our system. I think, for me, there's a lot of great things. Stewart hitting the home run, our offense continuing to fight when we're down, and then we give up the lead, we fight back. A lot of good things happen. Taylor Smart running that ball hard out in the 12th inning to get on base and then steal second to allow Scott Price to win the game. But for me, Eric Martin's the man of the day, the vol of the day. You look at all the offensive numbers, and there's probably some pretty gaudy numbers, but boy, that young man who hasn't pitched a whole lot kind of showed the rest of the pitching staff how it's done. And it couldn't happen to a better guy. He really went out there and kept it simple. He threw strikes, he spun the ball, he changed speeds, and he made a great play off the mound on that bunt in the one inning. So we'll use that as a learning lesson tomorrow when I reconvene with the pitchers. And you know, we've got it's the lack of consistency. I've been very happy the way we've pitched the last two weekends. We've pitched really well. And you know, I don't know if it's lack of focus, taking the game for granted, taking the opponent for granted. I tried to prepare the pitchers today. I knew Morehead State had a very good offensive team. Their numbers don't lie. I mean, they're hitting over 300. And there's not many teams we have faced this year that have those kind of numbers. They have some guys that can hit the ball out of the ballpark. And I told them we were going to have to be at our best to allow this team, our team, to win today. And that definitely wasn't our best. And may have been the worst, to be honest with you.
That was what I was going to ask. Is just, it seemed like y'all pitched really well over the weekend, and with the exception of Martin, no one seemed to be able to find the plate tonight.
Well, you know, I'll start out with the obvious. You know, Kyle didn't set the tone, just like Peter Lindstrom didn't set the tone last week. Kyle didn't set the tone. I had a pitch limit on him going in this weekend, and then we hand the ball off to Marks, and he had a good inning. And then the troubling thing for me is that our pitchers pitch well when there's not a lot of pressure going on. Then we get base runners on, and we're all out of character. I mean, the walk part bothers me, but it's how those walks were created. A lot of four-pitch walks where it's not even close. And I watch these guys throw every day. People out there might not believe that, but I watch these guys throw every day, and those same characteristics don't happen in the bullpen. So something is changing when we walk across the white line and they say play ball and there's a competition. We're changing, we're out of control, and it's not translating to success. And it's that group of guys. You know, I think for the most, a big portion of this year, those midweek guys have gone in and stayed with their routine and have put up some good numbers. But lately we haven't done that, and we need to get that fixed quickly. I plan on playing next week sometime, and those guys are going to have to step up and get some big outs for us somewhere in that tournament for us to continue playing as a team.
You knew probably going into the extra innings that you're going to have to throw somebody that hadn't had a lot of experience. What made you turn to Eric and just...
Well, it's between Eric and Sabes, and with all the right-handed hitters they had, I chose Eric, and I know he, you know, his forte is he spins a little slider and has a good changeup, and we sneak the fastball by guys, and he did a great job with that. And like I said, it couldn't happen to a nicer kid, a team player. He's one of the favorite guys on the team, and I know the guys were really proud that he stepped up and did what he did tonight. That was big for our guys because he's so popular on our team.
Scott returns to the leadoff role for the first time, I think, since late March. You know, not just the walk-off, but five hits tonight. Is that something that, you know, you see as a comfortable spot for him, and moving forward that could be a permanent thing?
Well, you know, we met, like we do all the time, we met as a coaching staff, and we kind of went over different portions of the season. And we looked at what our team record was with Scott Price leading off, what our record was with other guys leading off. So we kind of went back to the percentage of what's going on. And what we kind of did, AJ's been struggling a little bit, is we've kind of stacked the top four hitters as four of our better hitters. And nothing against AJ. AJ's going to continue to work and continue to be a great hitter for us. But that's a pretty tough tandem to get through, those first four guys. And Scott and I met today and met over some things and cleared the air with just different stuff. And it's funny because I told him, I said, hey, you don't need to go out and prove to everyone that you're worthy of being in this lineup and go 4-for-4. Wade did better than that. I think he was 5 for 7. He did better with the game-winning hit. And in fact, his first thing he said to me right now before I came in here is, what time are we meeting tomorrow morning? Because he wants to have that. And I've said it, and I said this to Scott today. Just like there's pressure in my position, there's pressure in my assistant coach's position. That's what life is. And I told him he's one of the better hitters on this team, and he can help this team be a really good lineup if he just stays in character and does what Scott Price does. And it's not a secret we had a lot of success offensively tonight because Scott Price was a big part of that. Other guys had big parts too. Taylor Smart got on base 5 times, I think. That's huge. It was a great offense tonight. It was a very poor pitch game by not just us, but by the other team too.